Good evening. The bodies of Jesse Baird and Luke Davies have finally been found, a week after the couple disappeared from a Paddington home. Their remains were discovered in surfboard bags on a property at Bungonia near Goulburn. Detectives tipped off by the police officer who allegedly murdered them.
The sad and lonely end for Jesse Baird and Luke Davies. The search is over and the heartbreak is now as raw as ever.
Whilst this news may bring some solace to the Baird and Davies families, I know this would be incredibly heartbreaking for them, and as the Commissioner has said, our sympathies are with them.
It took a snap media conference late this afternoon to deliver the news two families and a country had been waiting for and dreading.
We're very confident that we have located Luke and Jesse.
The discovery on a property in Bungonia already on the radar of investigators.
There are two surf bags have been found, some other which has been covered with some debris. There's some other items of interest of significance.
The breakthrough came as police managed to unlock the secrets of the alleged killer, Constable Beau Lamar Condon. The 28-year-old had spent the last 4 days in jail saying nothing. But today, a homicide squad detective cracked the silence.
They attended Silverwater Jail and spoke to the accused. As a result of that, he provided assistance.
This is the first time that he has willingly told us information.
Luke Davies and Jesse Baird, who once dated Lamar Condon, were allegedly shot dead with the off-duty officer's police gun last Monday week.
Well, we're in this position that a police firearm was used, and that can never happen again.
The cop is then accused of moving their bodies in a hired van, travelling through Sydney south to Bungonia twice and then on to Newcastle before turning himself into police on Friday. A friend who travelled with Lamar Condon to Bungonia the first time later led police to the area, but the search yesterday only delivered disappointment.
We went home last night extremely deflated, but it's not in our nature to give up, so we rallied again this morning and have come upon a wonderful result for the families.
It's believed the bodies were initially dumped in a dam on a property on Hazelden Road on late Wednesday. It will be alleged Lamar Condon later returned and moved them to their final resting spot on a fence line of a farm on Gerrara Road, 20 minutes away. It's now a crime scene. The couple had been missing for 8 days. The scene of the murder turned into a shrine as family, friends and strangers stop to grieve.
I came here to lay some flowers for my friend Luke and for Jesse.
Police were investigating one of their own, adding to the enormous pressure to solve the case.
Attracted the world's attention, let alone Australia's. It's been a horrendous and a horrific murders. And once again, we pass on our sympathies to the families.
Small comfort for those left behind. Damien Ryan, Nine News.
All right, let's go straight to Nine's Alex Heinke at the scene in Bungonia. Alex, as we come to you tonight, what's the situation?
Well, Pete, police have only been here for the last few hours and we've just actually come to a vantage point where you can see the entrance to this property. We'll just take a look now. There are a lot of police down there. You can see the search and rescue van. We've seen detectives coming and going. Forensics are down there as well as a lot of plainclothes officers. But not far from those vehicles are the bodies of Luke and Jesse. Tonight, they remain inside those surfboard bags they were found in only a few hours ago, and their parents have been invited to the crime scene. Whether or not they accept that invitation is yet to be finalised. But Pete, either way, it will be remaining a crime scene for some time.
Okay, Alex, thank you. Damien Ryan's with me in the studio. Damien, how did police get that breakthrough to convince Lamar Condon to talk?
Well, Pete, police had tried several times to speak to the suspect, but only today were they given the green light after he received legal advice. Now, lead investigator, Chief Inspector Glenn Brown, went to Silverwater Jail for a meeting at 11 a.m. By 1 p.m, just 2 hours later, police in Bungonia had found the bodies in the two surf bags. Now, Pete, Lamar Condon is due to face court on April 23, and of course he remains in Silverwater Jail.
Damo, thank you. And the police minister and commissioner are in talks with Mardi Gras officials to come to a compromise over Saturday's parade. Yesterday, police were uninvited to participate due to the anger over the murders, allegedly by a serving officer. Late today, a deal to allow police to march, but not in uniform, was being considered. Australian Federal Police have separately dropped out of attending, saying they acknowledge how some in the community are feeling about the blue uniform.